Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay, and my trip around the world from the comfort of my swingy, spinny chair, my office chair. Now, sorry, I've got fleas. Where are we now? We're in Africa. I don't know what that was, but we're in Africa, in East Africa, I believe. And if I'm not very good with geography, I have to get a passport to get out of London. Right, so, even to South London, you know. So, we're in Kenya. And this beer is Tusker. Been going in Kenya since 1927. I kind of find something a bit funny. If you look, if anyone knows about art, you know these little things when you smile, these cheek things. When you're drawing art, you do kind of semi-crescent the eyes to denote these cheek things pushing the eyes into a sort of downwards crescent, like that. So that elephant there is smiling, big grin, like big cheeks pushing his eyes up, if you can see what I mean. So there's a big smile on his face, right? Now the elephant on the front is, the beer gets its name from the elephant on the front called Tusker. And Tusker was the elephant that killed the original brewery owner in it. You think that's great. So I have him smiling on there, but there you go. Brewed in East Africa since 1922, named after the elephant that killed George Hurst, one of the brewery's founders. Tusker claims a special heritage in being one of the first beers in East Africa. Over the years, this unique lager is, of course, snuff small writing, become a part of East Africa's rich tradition, and it goes on. I'll let you have a look at the rest of it if you can. There we go, there, like that. Because I can see it bigger on the camera there. It's larger on the camera, but it's back to front, and I'm dyslexic as it is. So, there we go, that's the front, that's the back. There's the website. Whoop, there we are. Let's crack it open and see what the insides are like. Now, I'm hoping this is going to be a good lager, but, you know, I've been abused a lot by lagers. It ain't fizzed over everywhere, at least. There's the very beautiful and very funny, I believe anyway, because I've got a sixth sense of humour. The very funny laughing Tusker there. Gotcha! I've got a sixth sense of humour, I'm sorry. That's what you call a beer with bite. Right, let's see how we go. Pour it out and we'll have a sniff. Kind of already smelling quite nice, kind of malty. Do you notice I'm pouring heads now and again these days? I'm getting more and more pouring heads. Much to my own disgrace, but there you go. Anyway, there's your head. Lovely white fluffy head. Now this doesn't look kind of that E405 sort of head, it isn't meringue-y. Whenever you see them meringue sort of egg, you know, eggy looking heads on them, quite often it's that 405. So, let's see how we go. There's the carbonation. I'll show you to tip the glass towards me a little bit, and you can see it running up the side of the glass. Hello. You can already see through there. You can kind of get an idea of the colour. I'll get a bit of white. There's my little receipt on the side there. Look at that lovely golden colours. Almost glowing, that is. Sliding about my little slidey chair. Let's have a sniff. It's smelling a slightly generic, you know, slightly kind of popsy. Mmm. Yeah, you're getting kind of rich tea biscuits. You're getting a slight bread note, slight bread crust, but that's kind of that processed bread crust rather than the fresh bread. And that kind of, you know, like your mother's pride or whatever it is, those kind of square loaves and that you get. Those, that kind of bread. And a little bit of kind of grapefruit pith, tiny bit of like a lemon pith, grapefruit zest. Right, let's dive in. That's nice. Yeah, that's quite nice. It smells very generic on the nose. But on the taste, that's really quite pleasant. That's quite nice. It tastes smooth, it tastes malty. There's a little bit of something sticky there, almost kind of sugary in it, yeah, but it's kind of, it tastes malty as well. You can taste, instead of, you know, a lot of brewers, it seems, are using sugar instead of malt and then putting colouring in and stuff like that. Whereas this actually does taste malt. There's a stickiness of the sugar in it. Slightly sticky, but it's really, it's quite fine, quite nice. Oh yeah, that's nice, I like that. There's none of these kind of big fruity notes on it, but it's one of these fine little, any bits in it? No, so it's not bottle conditioned, but that doesn't really matter. A quick word on bottle conditioning and kind of live yeasts and things like that. Not all live yeast lagers, beers, are kind of good. Not all real ales are good. Pardon me. And not all stuff that ain't real ales, you know, without the live yeast. Not all stuff that's bottled, that's, you know, brewery conditioned. Not all that is bad, you know, so it's kind of, you just have to take it how it is, you know, so not all stuff that ain't real ale is bad, and not all stuff that's real ale is good, you know. So you just take it for what it's worth, try it out. If it's pure good, if it's a good brewery, you kind of got a chance, you know. That's really nice. Oh, that is good. Beer only, it says on the bottle. Well, trip around the world. I've stopped off in Kenya. And that is really nice. I think it said on there that it's from spring water from the base of Mount Kenya. Oh no, grains from the base of Mount Kenya. Choicest hops and water that springs from the renowned Abendar mountain ranges. So that's kind of, yeah, it's nice. Good. Go out, buy it and try it. If you see it, buy it and try it. Nice. Chin chin, bottoms up. Cheers. Skull. up your bottoms. Cheers.